YouTube model building community, Chris Chapman coming at you from the Rusty Nuts Model Shop again. We're going to go ahead and continue working on our motor. I've got, as we left off last time, the paint on the block, the heads and everything. Did the back part in the sponging technique when it cut off on me and frustrates me where I have to hold this camera. It's hard to see. I'm going to try doing something a little different with the lighting. Hopefully this will work, and if it does, then cool, but seems to come in a lot better this way with my main lights off. So, as I get back here and start doing work, hopefully you guys will be able to see it. What we're going to work on today is the chipping. I was going to start out in the other video, but it's kind of getting long, so what I do is I got a little bottle of water here. I'm going to just squirt some into my tray. Now for the chipping effect, I've already explained how it works. The hairspray holds the, or puts a seal in there so it won't pull away. You can get these brushes here at Michael's, Hobby Lobby. I've even seen them over at Walmart. And I like to use these. You can also use toothpicks. So what I do is I got these old Hobby brushes, just the testers ones. And you want to turn around. And add water. Let me just take a brush here. I'll go ahead and start on this cylinder here. I'll put some water up pretty thick. Get it down on the side over here. And you can see I've got a pretty good coat of water right there on it. I want to give that a minute. Get a little bit more down in there. That's going to soften that paint back up, being acrylic. That's where you turn around and you take your brush. You just come in here and kind of rub. And in doing so, it peels off the paint that I had on there. Hopefully you can see how that's chipping that off of there, giving it a chipped effect. Coming up on the top up here, gonna work on getting some of that. Certain areas you just get this here wet. You can see how much water I've got on there. I just let it soak in and soften up the paint. Try to get around areas that will, along the edges, get your nuts and your bolts on this particular motor. Now once you get to a certain point, now just use some tissue. I'm gonna wipe off the paint or the water and dry it up a little bit so I can look at it. See, that's looking really good now. Gives just a little bit of worn out look to it. And, you know, depending on what your plans are, how rusty you want it to go, will depend on how much you actually scrape off of the paint. And this also comes in really handy for this section where I want to take all the paint off of this, because I'll actually be sanding that down. I have another piece that I'll be gluing onto the front right there. Now I come down, and you want to try to get the lower spots. Because the low spots are where most of your water will accumulate and sit down in there. Let's go ahead and let that kind of soak in for a second. Now this is where your toothpick comes in. Getting down inside there. I just kind of scrape. The good thing about it is this turned around and allows you to get down into the low spots, like on these manifold areas, where the brush would normally take off the upper part. The toothpick will scrape out down inside there. Every once in a while you kind of wipe off the brush again or your toothpick. But that's what I want to go for along this area here is the low spots. You can see how the paint has stayed on the upper part. But it's disappearing down on the low spot. So then we come over here with the brush part. I've got this other bigger one, and this is very, very stiff brush. Looks like we need more water. See, just kind of tap it, hit it, do all kinds of. You can either sit it on there like that, then just twist it. It pulls it off. Oh yeah, you can see that's looking good. Now let's go ahead and get down this area here. We want to let that soften up. Now in this kind of area, we'll go ahead and suck some of that water up off of it. This here, I like to dab it and twist, dab twist. And in doing that, it just thins it out where you can see how the paint looks like it's just fading and slowly disappearing, because the water would run off of that pretty quick, of which it would get caught. Let's get the toothpick here down along this edge. So we'll go ahead and just scrape some of this off, maybe a little up in there. But there's that edge right there, and just kind of pulls it off, and you can see how it's starting to show rusty and worn out. Another area. See, with this, I keep dipping it in the water because I get in a hurry and it just puts too much on there. Now, with the edges on like the oil pan here, you'll notice how easy that paint's coming off, but yet we still got our rust primer down underneath it. Once we get to that point, I'm going to grab the smaller brush, just in certain areas along kind of hit it right along the edges of the seam. Go across the back right there. Then we'll use this. And you can see how it's kind of blending in. There we go, look at that. That is looking nice. Let's get some of this down inside here torn out. Get some water. Trying to build it up a little bit too much there. Again, we'll just let it soak for a minute. Actually, not a minute. Doesn't take very long at all. Let's go ahead and dip that. And I bet it'll be ready now. Oh yeah. I just dropped my brush. See, that's coming out nice. Go ahead and I gotta remember, I keep doing this. Use this brush because you kind of control how much water you put on this way. You kind of put a little bit too much on over there just a second ago. Now this one here, I'm going to just kind of scrape it. There we go, it's starting to loosen up. Let's go ahead and get the water off of it. You can see how it just peels that paint right off. And there's the front of it. It was just that quick, and now we got ourselves a rusted motor. Now, what I'm going to do is take my pre-mixed flat black. Got a 50-50 mix with the washer fluid for my airbrush. Now this is kind of a nice little way to kind of dirty it up a little bit more. Seeing them. Looking at the video here as I'm doing this, that's really coming in nice. You guys are able to see it really well. But man, it's a pain in the butt because it's dark in here and it's kind of hard to see what I'm doing. But that's alright. Now, Where did I put my brush? Oh, brushy. There we go. And we'll use this one. This one here's got a long brush on it. These brushes, I got three of them for $1.99 with free shipping from China. Not the best brushes in the world, but for what I want to do, this is going to be perfect. I'm going to dip my brush here, get the bristles wet. And just, these here will soak up a lot. Let's see if you can see it. Where is it? It's going to be kind of hard to see. But it picks up a lot of paint. I like to just kind of splotch it on here really quick. And once I get it splotched on, and come through here and just take your tissue. And this is kind of a form of a wash. It's just a little bit thicker. Adds a little more detail. And we will be doing more detail with the washes here in a bit. So we'll grab that kind of brush. And grab this. Try to get a little bit more on there. Over here. I just put little dots. Dab it here and there. And then you come and just pull. And that there leaves a little bit of black, dirt, grimy, greasy look. Looks really good when you get it down. Kind of get some of this stuff here as well. We'll get some down here. And you just want to dab it and kind of move it so that it doesn't pull the black paint away. But you can see how it's adding a little bit more texture to it. We'll go down here to the bottom. And I'm just going to dab it there and dab it there and a little bit through there. And the good thing about it is, as I do this, I can take off as much as I want. I can spread it. You can see it's getting these little black patches. And again. And this just kind of smooths it out and feathers it on in there. And you can use different colors as well. Do orange or yellows or purples to get different coats and different colors. But you can really see it right there on that cylinder head. It just dirties and grimes it up a little bit. So from this point, I'm happy with the way this is looking right now. I've got my carburetor. I dropped it in here about 20 minutes ago. This is LA's Totally Awesome degreaser. Put it inside this strainer. took 20 minutes and them things are already completely dechromed. Got the carburetor, I got a mirror, and I've got the shift lever. So I'm gonna go ahead and get this carburetor here cleaned up here, and we'll go ahead and get that fixed up, and I'll get some stuff ready to get the wiring put in here and get a few detailed pieces put on it. Then we'll come back and show you how I do my details on my wiring and everything. So we will take a quick break from this point. Grab yourself a beverage and a snack if need be, and we will be back shortly. All right, we've got the motor all here ready to go. I'm going to turn around and do some dry brushing on the bolts. All right, let's get that off again. Grab my magnifier so I can see. Now to do this, I'm going to use moccasin brown. It's a lighter brown to show a different color. Now this here, once you load up your brush, then you swipe most of it off on a paper towel here. And so you got paint up inside. So now you just lightly go over where the bolts are on the high spots. It's very, very, very lightly. You don't want the paint to get on anything except for the bolts. You can see how those are kind of sticking out a lighter color. I'll go ahead and do it one more time. Very, very, very lightly dry brush it. And every one of them bolts will turn around and pop. Because now they're a different color contrast. So you can see the difference in the different shades. So now we've got a bolt that's obviously a different material than the heads, that's going to rust in a different manner, so they'll stick out. One thing that I do like to use for my dry brushing, let me hurry up and get this other side real quick, and I'll show you a couple little techniques or products, that's the word I'm looking for, that come in very, very handy. Oh yeah, that's looking nice. Don't mean to toot my own horn, but toot toot! You can see the contrasting color of the bolts to the valve cover there. It's exactly what we want. Now the problem is we have bolts down inside there. I cannot get down into it with the dry brushing. So that's going to require me to turn around and use a toothpick. And I want each one of them bolts to turn around and show. Boy, my birds, they're on one today. They're like, hey, the camera's rolling. It's our time of 15 seconds of fame. If I didn't like them so much, it'd be their last. Never mind. Let's get that bolt down in there. Silly birds. And if you happen to get the paint on the actual head or manifold like this, that's not going to hurt because the rust does kind of run off on it. And as it does that, it will get onto the other areas. Now that my area that I had dry brushes drying up, I'm going to go over it one more time real quick. Very lightly. All right. Guess I don't need my hands up there. And there we go. You can see how I've got the bolts all showing is rusted. So it's that easy. Turn around and get that dry brushing. Now when it comes up to the dry brushing, if you go to the dollar store, for a dollar, you could get these three items. This is what I just used for my dry brushing. It's a makeup applicator for eyeshadow and blush that ladies use. I use this for my dry brushing, and once it's done, I just go ahead and wash it and rinse it out here in my windshield washer fluid. And that'll go get all the paint out of the brush, so it'll be good to go next time I need it. See, that's the thing about the dry brush, and you get a lot of paint up inside there. Takes a couple of times, but now all I gotta do is let that dry out and it's ready for the next dry brushing event that we do. But these three, you got this actually works really good for scraping when you want to remove some stuff. We'll be using that later. This is a great applicator for powders, of which we'll get into in a little bit. But this is the powders that I use. This was a dollar at the dollar store. You open it up and I've got all kinds of different powders right there. And rusts, dirt, tan, sand. And it comes with its own little applicator. And then you get these other ones for the dry brushing and stuff. But that right there costs a buck, and you've got 3, 6, 9, 12 colors that will go a long ways for a dollar. For my shinier builds and my hot rod muscle cars, I got this one for a dollar. Again, comes with its own applicator. That's what I use to do my it's a metallic colors, and I use them for my exhaust systems to give it the tarnished look to it. You've got the different blues and purples and different shades that you can use your applicator. You just brush it in there and stuff. Again, a dollar. I could do a lot of sets of exhaust with this here. So, little tips there. This is my main thing, is all four of these brushes. You get this one, and this one. Actually, there's three brushes in this kit. This actually came with that other one. So there's four in the one, these three right here, for a dollar. Ladies makeup sections over at the dollar store, you can find all kinds of great little doohickey stuff. that you can use on your model building. And you just saw how dry brushing with that fluffy brush really makes them head bolts pop. So again, that's my little tip on products that are handy for this. That's going to finish up this video segment. I am going to go ahead and get the rest of the parts on the motor, get the tranny done up, carburetor, get everything on. And this video is kind of getting a little bit long, so I'm going to end it with this so that we can go ahead and put the motor together and then just finish this up and we'll get the exhaust done. So we'll have more coming up shortly. Again, Chris Chapman, Rusty Nuts Model Shop. Thanks for watching.